Hello, this is the LEGO Creator Sunset Street Bike. It's a 3-in-1, and in this one video, I will show you all three official builds. I'll start with the smallest build. It's this no-fairing sport bike, kind of street fighter style, and I mostly prefer the view of it from the upper rear because the shape of that tank is really nice. It's kind of low profile, it's wide, it looks very aggressive. I also appreciate the slight angle that they got onto the seat at the back. This has a hard tail on it, but you can still kind of flex the parts just a little bit in there. It kind of makes it seem like you got a little bit of suspension action. No suspension action up at the front, but you are able to steer the front fork from side to side, a limited amount. That's limited by the position of the handlebars, which you can pull out, but then also the assembly that holds the headlight, because once you go right to there, if you go any further than that, you're going to start changing the angle of the headlight. Looks like it might have a little bit of fairing just in the center, the forward part of the frame here, and it looks pretty much the same from either side. The only major difference is that these wheels, you know, like most LEGO wheels, have a different view or a different design on either side. I actually prefer this side myself. Here's the next larger build, a dragster, which is not intended to be a perfect replica of any real drag racing class of vehicle that I'm aware of, but that's cool. It looks fun, it looks fast, it looks maybe a little bit futuristic. With those big tires, it is able to get some good speed and hold on to some good momentum and not be slowed down by terrain. So that's actually literally good for play, having the bigger tires on there and being real rubber. Kind of has a spoiler, a big old spoiler on the back rather than a traditional wing. That's interesting. I really like this cockpit section right here. All those lines just go together really well with this design of windscreen. There are some small gaps around the top of it, but that really doesn't bug me. I like this line, I like that line, I like the lines of the windscreen itself. Small little wheels up at the front, the tires of which are not used on the main build, we'll see in just a minute. No suspension on this one or anything, no actions, nothing that can be changed other than the angle of the spoiler back here. Well, that's a good thing. Actually kind of looks kind of sleek like that, but you want to see that up just a bit. A little bit of area that kind of increases the height of the whole thing. As you go from the front to the back, the cross section really opens up even down on the base of it, because they use the inverted round curved pieces under here to hold together part of the frame, but then that kind of ends rather abruptly. It steps up just a little bit, but kind of looks like it's part of a driver compartment there. And around the back, I don't know what's up with this, but it's just some sort of engine air fuel management related item. Could be something from the future, could be fusion power or something. Where's the gearbox though? There's nothing to get power to the rear axle. All right, here we go. This is the main build, the Sunset Superbike street bike itself. This is looking nice, and this also makes really good use of the windscreen piece. It was first introduced with Nexo Knights, and they've just done it in a plain tinted color. The transparent black or smoke has the small headlights here, which are facing a little bit down, but I think it all goes together well. Again, the lines here of the windscreen, and then using these wedge plates, I think those go together very well. Very aggressive angle to the seat, and also the exhaust, you know, the mufflers there. And this one does have suspension. You see the single spring, the single strut there, and that works nicely. You know, it has some tension to it. It holds itself up, but it's right on the edge. So as soon as you start to put a little bit of pressure on it, a little bit of extra weight, it starts to compress. It feels good. It's actually compressing itself ever so slightly. So it's really within its suspension right now. And you still have the ability to steer the front wheel, although this one's even more limited now. I can bring out these handlebars just a bit, but that really doesn't help because it's being blocked at the front of the tank. Got the little filler lid right there, a couple of tail lights on the back. And the shaping of the fairing is very nice all the way down here. I appreciate the continuation of the orange as it goes down and starts to turn inward, and then a little bit of the cheese slope piece here just makes it feel very, very smoothed over. That's nice. And once again, looks pretty much the same from either side except for the wheels. As you look through the gaps behind the fairing, there's a lot of stuff going on in there. It's quite a bit that actually got built with small pieces. Makes it seem like there's a lot of mechanical stuff going on, even though it's just structural, and most of what you see there is just to get your attachments of the fairings on the side, and then also to angle the fork. So the pivot point for that comes up right in here that ultimately connects all the way back way inside of the frame. But it's nicely done. This was a good build. For a motorcycle based set, I'm glad that there are two motorcycle build options here. I think that motorcycle fans will appreciate that, and yet you get the dragster as another option, which is completely different. However, the bikes are quite different as well. The forks have similar builds, very similar builds, and the handlebars are the same. But the rest, I mean, you can see just the difference in size alone, not to mention the fact that this is a hardtail versus having the suspension here. But, you know, enough is different here that it really feels like you're building two different bikes. So it's not just kind of taking the fairing off of this and locking the rear and you're done. I also appreciate the parts with the recolor of this windscreen, and also down at the neck of the steering column, there's a 2x2 round tile with hole down the center in black. And all the pieces that were used to make these mufflers are cool too. However, I do not like the blue at all, nor the brown. I believe that these brown axles with stoppers at the ends are color locked, so they'll only make them in those colors, so you really have no choice there. But it's really unfortunate to see the blue showing through in some spots. It's less pronounced in this major build, just some small things. That one piece right there in the Street Fighter build really, really bugs me though. The other smaller ones, you know, are a little bit more hidden. But then on the dragster build, where you go from the tint to the white to the blue to the red, all in that one small space, and it's also visible from the back, but mostly just around the driving compartment. I don't like that at all. Really wish they had chosen something that didn't contrast so much, that's just not necessary for these pieces to be so visible with such a different color. Lego obviously likes to make motorcycle sets, and that's a good thing because there are a lot of motorcycle fans out there, and I feel that this set does good justice to those fans with the two major builds, in addition to giving you, you know, an alternate, something completely different to try out. But I think older fans especially will really want to do a lot of part substitutions on their favorite build or builds of this in order to get a much, much more displayable, more presentable finished product that you'll be a lot happier with. Just removing a lot of the unnecessary changes of color from part to part. That's it for my views on this set, but please do share what you think about it, including if you completely disagree with my thoughts. Thank you in advance for your feedback down below, and I'll talk to you again very soon.